During the 2016 presidential race, Hillary Clinton's health was a topic of significant concern, and for a good reason. Throughout the race, Hillary seemed to move about the countryside like a drunken sailor passing out, slurring her speech, and tripping over her own feet. And, of course, the mainstream media was there every step of the way, ready to help cover up these incidents with excuses and lies. To make matters worse, Hillary's doctors came forward giving the two-time failed presidential candidate a clean bill of health. But now the truth has been revealed, and it is worse than we could have imagined. To say we dodged a bullet by not having Hillary Clinton as president is a definite understatement. But now newly released documents prove just how true that was. If you remember back in 2016, as the election was heating up, Hillary Clinton was plagued with a series of odd health issues ranging from severe coughing fits to fainting spells. Of course, the mainstream media did their best in 2016 to paint these medical problems in the best possible light. But still, they had many people questioning the validity of their claims now. As we head into 2018, the truth is revealed. And it turns out everyone, including Hillary's doctor, was covering how sick she truly was. As it turns out, Hillary Clinton was diagnosed with a condition called subcortical vascular dementia, which is a type of dementia caused by widespread microscopic areas of damage to the deep layers of white matter in the brain. And her doctors hid it from the American people when then presidential candidate Hillary Clinton had her famous fainting episode, which necessitated her being escorted away from a campaign rally and helped into her waiting van. Her personal physician played down the event, writing it off to a bout of pneumonia. Not everyone in the medical community was convinced. However, the day after Clinton's public collapse, a New York Times reporter who boasts an MD, after his name suggested she was sicker than her doctor was letting on and that further tests needed to be administered to quell concerns about her fitness to serve as president if elected, her campaign released an update of a July 2015 letter from her doctor attesting to her overall good health. The only caveat voiced by Clinton's personal physician, Lisa Bardak of MT Kisco, NY, was that she had developed two new medical conditions in 2016, a sinus and ear infection in the winter and pneumonia that month. Neither was permanent or would impair her ability to govern. Now a doctor's diagnosis from 2014 has been made public by via Julian Assange that reveals that Clinton shows signs of advancing subcortical vascular dementia after a MMSE mini mental state examination was performed. The patient performed significantly lower on today's test than when tested in 2013. The patient is also showing signs of having more complex partial seizures. The doctor who made that diagnosis? Lisa Bardak of MT Kisco, NY. The symptoms of this disease are a short-term memory, changes in speech, forgetfulness, an unsteady gait, clumsiness or frequent falls, and changes in personality or mood, most likely in the form of apathy, irritability, and depression. And if you remember, we saw these symptoms on display on regular basis throughout the 2016 presidential race. For instance, when Hillary Clinton was speaking during a campaign rally, It appeared that she had a momentary blackout and dizzy spell which was caught on camera. Then there was the time that Hillary Clinton froze in mid-sentence and a secret agent had to prompt her to continue speaking. Now, is this someone that should have been allowed to run for president? Not at all. And what makes it worse is that the mainstream media helped push this very sick woman onto the American people. You see, the left does not care who they hurt in this country as long as they get who they want in office to continue to push their destructive liberal policies. The left knew that Hillary Clinton was incredibly sick. And they still did what they could to get her into the White House to protect Barack Obama's legacy. Thankfully, that entire plan was thwarted. And the American people elected Donald Trump. But that does not negate the harm these people have done. Drive. Lisa Bardak should be questioned concerning her role in misleading the American people about Hillary Clinton's condition and face some punishment. However, it is highly doubtful that will happen considering we are still waiting to see Hillary Clinton charged with the numerous crimes she has committed. Though, if we the people continue to push for Hillary Clinton and all those that surround to be questioned, we may see justice.